Welcome to All the Best. I'm Meryn Winchester. This episode, The Sister and Mum, is a bit of a heart warmer. Families come in all different forms, and a family is not just the people you were born to. Our first story was produced by Liam Neerham. He met Leslie Flanders, a foster mum, and was inspired by her story. Here is Liam to tell you more about how this story came to be.
Unfinished Business is a photographic essay by Belinda Mason, telling the stories of 30 Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people with disabilities living in remote, regional and urban communities. The impact of disabilities in these communities is profound, as up to 50% of Aboriginal people experience disability. The exhibition was opened this week in Geneva by the Director General of the United Nations in conjunction with the Human Rights Council's 26th session. My brother and I were lucky enough to interview many of these extraordinary people, from Uncle Yami Lester, who was blinded in the atomic test of the 1950s, to Marlon Noble, who has an intellectual disability and was imprisoned for 10 years without charge. One of these people we interviewed was Auntie Leslie Flanders, a remarkable woman who fostered over 40 Aboriginal children, including those with disabilities. Here is her story.
I'm Leslie Flanders, and I was born in Bowerville of the Gambangi tribe many years ago. My mother had 13 children, and she never had a sick day in her life until she turned 68. Then she became a diabetic, had a leg amputated. I nursed her here at my house. She was the most powerful woman, and yeah, she just taught me to care. 82. My two sons were going to school and I started having a dream about a baby. The baby was crying and I'd walk up to the crib and I could never see the face of this child. And this went on probably a half dozen times, and one of the docks workers that I knew, and I said to her, "Oh, I want to see you, can you call into my house on your way back to Coffs?" And she did, and I said to her, "How do I go about fostering a child? Because I don't want to have any more children." The docs worker came and we were talking, and I said, "How do I put my name down for fostering?" And she said, "You have to do this, blah, 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 and that." And I said, "Okay, well, I want to do it." I said, "I've got two boys, so I'd just like a little girl to complete my family." And she looked real strange at me. And she said, "Actually, we've got a little girl that we can't find a family for because she's got a disability." I said, "That's why I can't see her face." I've seriously lost count, but I had 4 permanent state wards. Probably 40-odd children I've had come through my house. I've been a foster parent for 28 and a bit years, and I'm just taking care of my ex-sister-in-law's 3 daughters. So Penny is cerebral palsy, spastic quadriplegic and profoundly deaf. I had cochlear implant when he left here 6 months after I got her. And then 6 months after turn on, they realised that it worked really well, so we done the second one. And she's hearing now. It's taken a while for her to talk, but yeah. Paris is her triplet sister. She's been diagnosed as having mild cerebral palsy, and she also has a shunt to drain her brain fluid into her belly. The third triplet sister we lost 4 a year ago. She was severely disabled too, and I'm not sure what really happened to her, but she just went to sleep and didn't wake up. But she was profoundly deaf, severe cerebral palsy, and she was peg-fed. She couldn't have anything orally. And we lost her 4 years ago. So she's been gone. Yeah. Tegan is an 11-year-old, absolute drop-dead gorgeous child in every aspect of her life. Her beauty, her mental attitude. She's tuned into Penny and Paris more than people can ever understand how much. She's just a gift to these triplet sisters of hers. You'd never measure the kind of help just Tegan gives. They give me a reason to live and live life to the fullest. So just teaching them to be strong, black women is my goal in life, to be a successful parent. The foster children are more important to me than my birth children. Yeah, birth children come from your belly and you have to have them no matter what. You have to look after them no matter what. These foster children come from my heart, and it's a decision that I made with a sound, solid mind. I looked at every aspect of what I can do for them before I took them. And I knew I can not give them a better life, but a different life. Because I don't ever want to be a judge of another mother's way of mothering a child. I'm their tribal aunt. I am from the same tribe. So within my tribe, I am their mother because I'm of the same generation as their mother. And that means the world to me. So I've always thought people look at the disability rather than the ability, and I want to totally explore and help Penny with her abilities, because once you see their abilities, the world's their oyster. They can do anything, so she can live a full life.
Story was produced by Liam Neeram, who spoke with Leslie Flanders about what it's like to be a foster mum. They met whilst working on a project with the United Nations. She says she's made it her goal to be a great mum to all the kids that walk through her door, and what an inspiration she is. That's how I remember.